This is Rummy's Corner. Last Saturday night at the Wembley Arena, in a bout that was televised on the relatively new streaming app service known as DAZN, unified IBF WBA WBO heavyweight world champion Anthony Joshua defended his championship against challenger Kubrat Pulev. This was a mandatory defense for AJ's IBF title, and it was a solid performance from Joshua. AJ began patiently boxing without overextending himself or taking any unnecessary risks. His patience paid off in round three. About halfway through the round, Joshua drilled Pulev with a mean right. Joshua pounced on his wounded foe, he soon had him hurt again, and Pulev turned his back, prompting the referee to begin his count. Pulev survived the count, and before long, AJ had him down again. Pulev again beat the count and survived the round without further incident. AJ had seized the momentum as Pulev was trying to bide his time and regain his composure. Joshua remained patient and methodical as he continued outboxing the challenger over the next several rounds. Pulev managed to land a nice shot here and there, but whenever he did land, Joshua took them well. And Joshua was otherwise dictating the tempo and controlling the range of the action. In round 9, AJ delivered a series of wicked uppercuts that had Pulev down once more. Pulev beat the count, but not for long. Joshua delivered a booming right hand that had Pulev down yet again, and this time he was unable to beat the count. The fight was over. It was a 9th round knockout, and with the victory, Joshua retained his unified IBF WBA WBO Heavyweight World Championship. Amazingly, this was only the second heavyweight championship contest all year. The other one happened way back in February, before COVID-19 changed the entire boxing landscape and indeed the entire world as we once knew it. That was when WBC heavyweight champion Deontay Wilder put his title on the line in a long-awaited rematch against lineal heavyweight champion Tyson Fury. That battle of undefeated heavyweights, each of whom had a legitimate claim to the heavyweight crown, was broadcast on a joint ESPN-Fox pay-per-view event. The first encounter between Wilder and Fury had ended in a somewhat controversial draw, but there was nothing controversial about the outcome in their rematch. Tyson Fury simply dominated Deontay Wilder from start to finish. Fury began the fight committed to pressing the action in an effort to make Wilder fight going backwards. Fury dropped Wilder late in round 3, and while Wilder bravely battled on as best he could, the momentum was all Fury after that. Fury dropped Wilder again in round 5 when he landed a stinging left downstairs. Wilder's legs were gone, but still he battled, and still Fury continued executing his game plan in style. Fury never overextended, he never got reckless, and he continued taking care of business. Wilder was beginning to absorb a lot of punishment. Fury was breaking him down physically and mentally. Things finally came to an end in round 7 when Wilder's corner stopped the fight. It was a 7th round technical knockout, and Tyson Fury had just become the new WBC heavyweight champion. With 2020 drawing near an end, we are right in the midst of a critical period during this era of heavyweight history. It's amazing to think how different things were just a little over 5 years ago. Back then, Vladimir Klitschko was the long-reigning king of the heavyweight division. Klitschko was the unified IBF WBO WBA heavyweight champion, whose reign had lasted over 9 years, during which time he made an incredible 18 consecutive title defenses. Only the great Joe Louis and the Eastern Assassin, Larry Holmes, had more consecutive title defenses. But more impressive still, Klitschko hardly lost a round during his reign of dominance, and he was still considered head and shoulders above the rest of the best. But despite his impressive reign of dominance, Klitschko never became the undisputed heavyweight champion. Klitschko never held the WBC title, which belonged to his brother Vitaly for a number of years during Vlad's time at the top. And in January 2015, Deontay Wilder captured that title from Stiverne. The Klitschko era officially came to a sudden end on November 28, 2015, when Tyson Fury defeated Vladimir by 12-round unanimous decision. Fury won the fight by outmaneuvering Vladimir in one of his greatest strengths. Fury was able to dictate the range and control the fighting distance, which effectively neutralized the potent and methodical offense of the great Vladimir Klitschko. Fury's elusive movement was causing Vlad a lot of confusion. Klitschko was having difficulty finding a target because of Fury's hypnotic, herky-jerky rhythm. Fury made Vlad reluctant to punch. This was the first and only time that anyone ever effectively neutralized Vladimir's offense over the distance. It was a masterful performance from Fury that ushered in a new heavyweight era. But the IBF inexplicably stripped Fury of his title just 10 days after he beat Vladimir, and personal problems would keep Fury out of action for nearly 3 years. And the WBA and WBO would also strip him of their titles. But he never lost any of these titles in the ring. During Fury's absence, Deontay Wilder continued making successful defenses of his WBC belt. Meanwhile, Anthony Joshua became the IBF champion after beating Charles Martin in April 2016. And after making a couple of defenses of that belt, Joshua defended against former champion Vladimir Klitschko in April 2017. The vacant WBA belt was also on the line in this one. Klitschko looked far more comfortable than when we had last seen him against Fury, but Joshua was clearly outboxing Klitschko over the first 4 rounds. AJ was throwing more, he was landing more, and he was doing an excellent job of neutralizing Vladimir's jab. A big left hook from Joshua in round 5 led to a flurry that had Vladimir timbering down. But this knockdown emboldened Klitschko, and he began fighting more aggressively. In round 6, Vladimir nailed AJ with an explosive right that dropped the champion. Klitschko had seized the momentum, and his experience took over. Now it was Klitschko who was throwing more, landing more, and doing a better job neutralizing AJ's tactics. But even though Klitschko was controlling the action, slowly but surely, Joshua began sneaking in shots of his own. In round 11, Joshua rocked Vlad with a right uppercut, and he followed up and scored a knockdown. Klitschko beat the count, but a combination from Joshua had him down again. Still, Vlad beat the count and bravely battled, but Joshua was overwhelming him and referee David Fields waved it off. With that victory, AJ claimed the vacant WBA title. So AJ did something Tyson Fury did not. He stopped the great Vladimir Klitschko inside the distance. But that victory didn't come easy for AJ. Whereas Fury was never in any serious trouble at any point during his decisive win against a younger, fresher version of Vladimir. Unlike AJ, Fury did make it look easy against Klitschko. But styles make fights, and Vladimir's methodical approach matched up much better against Joshua, whose own style is more deliberate and predictable than someone like Fury, whose elusive rhythm never allowed Vlad to properly set his shots the way he could against Joshua. AJ added the WBO belt to his existing collection when he won a 12-round unanimous decision against Joseph Parker in March 2018. And Deontay Wilder had continued defending the WBC strap throughout this time frame. it was then that Fury finally made his long-awaited return to the squared circle. So by the middle of 2018, AJ and Wilder had emerged as the top two heavyweights during Fury's absence. This produced a very interesting and unique situation in heavyweight history, where we had three undefeated heavyweights, each of whom had a legitimate claim to call himself heavyweight champ. Wilder held the WBC belt, AJ had the unified IBF, WBA, WBO belts, and Fury was still the man who had dethroned long-reigning champion Vladimir Klitschko. And Fury never lost those titles in the ring. Ironically, all three belts that once belonged to Fury were in possession of AJ. For whatever reason, a mega bout showdown between Wilder and AJ never came together. It was a wasted opportunity, and it's a damn shame the fight didn't happen when it made the most sense. Wilder then defended his title against Fury in December 2018, after Fury had won a couple of comeback fights. Thus began the Fury-Wilder rivalry. Meanwhile, AJ got mixed up in an unexpected rivalry of his own, following his shocking upset loss at the hands of Andy Ruiz Jr. Ruiz won the Unified Championship from Joshua in June 2019, when he dropped Joshua several times before winning by 7th-round technical knockout. Joshua avenged the loss in December of last year, where he made several tactical adjustments to decisively beat Ruiz in their rematch by 12-round unanimous decision. That was AJ's last bout prior to beating Pulev last weekend. So during the entire Klitschko reign, we did not have an undisputed heavyweight champion. And with everything that has happened in the 5+ years of the post-Klitschko era, we still have not had an undisputed heavyweight champion. In fact, it's been more than 20 years since we've had one. The last one was Lennox Lewis, who unified every major world title of his day on November 13th, 1999, when he won his rematch against Evander Holyfield by 12-round unanimous decision. Of course, his undisputed reign was ruined when the WBA stripped Lennox of their alphabet trinket a few months later. And that was the last time we had an undisputed heavyweight champion. But the 1990s saw a handful of undisputed heavyweight champions. The decade began with Iron Mike Tyson holding that distinction. But no sooner did the 90s begin, Tyson suffered a shocking upset loss at the hands of Tokyo Douglas in February 1990. Douglas lost the undisputed crown against Evander Holyfield, and Holyfield lost it against Bo. The undisputed championship was then splintered when Riddick Bowe tossed the WBC trinket into a garbage can. It took almost 7 full years before Lewis successfully reunified the undisputed crown. That felt like a long 7 years to be without an undisputed heavyweight champion. But 7 years was nothing compared to the 20-year gap we're still experiencing right now. It's incredible. 20 years without an undisputed heavyweight champion. So here we are, at the end of 2020. Anthony Joshua currently holds the unified IBF, WBA, WBO heavyweight championship. And Tyson Fury is the WBC champion, who also has a legitimate claim to the more prestigious lineal heavyweight crown. This fight will never make more sense than it does right now. Tyson Fury versus Anthony Joshua for undisputed heavyweight supremacy. And the backstory between these two is like something out of a Hollywood script. You have the big name common opponent, who just so happened to be the heavyweight king of the previous era. And you also have the fact that between Fury's rivalry with Wilder and Joshua's rivalry with Ruiz, you have two outstanding elite heavyweights who both have exhibited a proven ability to totally adjust their styles going into a high-profile championship rematch. Things are perfectly aligned for a mega bout showdown between Fury and AJ. As of this moment, there are rumors that this fight might happen as early as next May. In theory, there could still be potential pitfalls involving Alexander Usyk being the number one mandatory for the WBO, and then it's possible that Wilder might have a legal path to getting a third fight with Fury. It's impossible to say how those potential roadblocks might figure into all of this, and then we also have the problems with COVID-19. Where boxing is dependent on the live gate, and the finances might be another potential stumbling block. But it's been more than 20 damn years since we've had an undisputed heavyweight world champion. Boxing fans deserve this. The last thing we need is another situation where the biggest fight in the entire sport that makes the most sense doesn't happen. We don't want another situation like we had with Riddick Bowe and Lennox Lewis. And hell, we don't even want a situation where AJ and Wilder blew it with a huge missed opportunity. So here's to hoping the boxing gods will bless us with an undisputed heavyweight showdown between Tyson Fury and Anthony Joshua. The timing will never be more perfect. Thanks for watching, everyone. I hope you enjoyed, and have a wonderful night. This is Rummy's Corner.